Talk about rivalry games in sports, and especially at the college level, they think of Michigan, Ohio State in football, Duke in North Carolina in basketball. Well, in men's volleyball in this part of the country, it's IBFW in Ball State. And tonight, the Volley Dons and the Cardinals are getting ready to battle once more here at the Henry Gay Sports Center. Hi, everybody. I'm Mike Moss. Welcome to another edition of IBFW Volleyball here on College 5 Sports. I'm joined by Women's Assistant Volleyball Coach Steve Florio, and it doesn't get any better, Steve. IBFW and Ball State.
No, it's a great rivalry. The student athletes from all the other teams get involved. Big crowds. We're only an hour and 15 minutes apart, so their fans drive up here and we drive down there. So look for a very exciting, electric atmosphere in tonight's match.
Both teams right in the thick of it for positioning in the MIVA. Right now, the Dons are in second place, 7-3 overall. The Cardinals in fourth place, 6-3. But throw the records out when these two teams get together.
Always throw the records out. Anything can happen. There's a lot of emotions. Of course, Coach Ball played at Ball State, and he always is looking to win. And like I said, the crowd is always, it's never just one-sided because the fans travel. So throw the records out.
Couple of key players for each team tonight, Steve.
Well, obviously for IPFW, you're looking at Josh Stewart and CJ Macias. And something interesting to note about CJ Macias is the last time IPFW played Ball State.
Select Comfort, the bed that adjusts on each side to your...
Now, CJ Macias will be on the left side, and that might give a different look to Ball State. For Ball State, you're looking at Meyer and McCarthy. Meyer can hit just about anything. McCarthy is a big old sophomore who's hitting out of the middle. So look for some good volleyball from both teams, with both teams having two very good go-to guys.
Steve said a big crowd coming here into the Gate Center. It ought to be a great one. The 10th-ranked Volley Dons taking on the 15th-ranked Ball State Cardinals. Stay tuned. Starting lineups and the opening serve are coming up next right here on College 5 Sports.
Life is good, but with a master's degree from IPFW, it could be even better. You could land a promotion, earn more money, become a leader in your field. And IPFW makes it easy. With affordable tuition, night and weekend classes, and more than 20 graduate programs from business to education to public affairs and more. Become the master of your future. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne, your graduate university.
IPFW's Mastodons on Parade were a big hit when the unique creations roamed the streets of Fort Wayne. A series of miniature mastodons will be offered to the public later this year, and you get to decide which ones will make the cut. Go to IPFWMastodons.org, click on the Mastodon Collectibles link, and pick your favorite. Voting runs from Monday, April 9th through Friday, April 20th. The top mastodon will be announced April 25th. Go to IPFWMastodons.org and vote for your favorite mastodon collectible.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Hilliard Gay Sports Center here on the campus of IPFW. Along with IPFW Women's Assistant Volleyball Coach Steve Florio, this is Mike Moss, and we are getting ready to call the action in tonight's MIVA volleyball match featuring the 15th-ranked Cardinals of Ball State University and the 10th-ranked Volley Dons of IPFW. Senior night here at the Gates Center, and there are five seniors, Steve Florio, on Arnie Ball's squad this year, and they're being honored for their accomplishments on the court as we speak.
Yeah, some very important players out there. It's in a way, it's going to show you what they'll be losing next year. It sort of gives you a glimpse of the future a little bit. Great setter in Colin Lundeen. He's been such an important part of this team over the past two seasons. Great players like Jerry Quillen and Jason Hemphill, who work as hard as anybody you can imagine in practice and in matches. Josh Collins, who's been a great outside hitter for the Dons, and Vitor Oliveira, a transfer from Brazil, who's really filled in nicely in the middle and even captured a MIVA Player of the Week award this year. So it's a very important group of five players that's going to finish their careers here in a few matches for IPFW.
And it's a very important match here tonight. It's, as we said a few moments ago, when you talk about rivalries in men's volleyball here in the Midwest, this is, if not the best, one of the best. And you've got a lot of things riding on this match. Mathematically, Ball State could still catch IPFW. You look at the all-time series, and the Cardinals lead 54-23. I think part of that's the fact that the IPFW head coach played volleyball at Ball State.
Maybe.
Last meeting was on February 23rd down at Worthen Arena in Muncie, and on that night, the Cardinals took out the Dons
3-1. IPFW, Steve, coming in on a three-match winning streak, having defeated Mercyhurst, Quincy, and Lewis. Lewis on the road Thursday night, a big win. And as you see there on the screen, they're in second place in the MEVA, 7-3, trailing first place Ohio State, who was 8-1. Loyola Chicago, 8-4. Ball State, 6-3. Lewis in fifth, Quincy in sixth, and Mercyhurst rounds out the conference standings. And as head coach Walton told me prior to the match, both of these teams could finish anywhere from second, third, fourth, or fifth, depending upon how things shake out. But you got to put all that aside. It is IPFW and Ball State.
Yeah, this is a crucial match for both teams as far as standings and rankings go. And pretty much, if IPFW wins, they pretty much lock up second place, and that's something you want to do.
Here's the starting lineups for the Ball State Cardinals. On one outside is Nick Meyer, a 6'8 senior out of Cincinnati. In the middle is Matt McCarthy, a 6'8 sophomore from Wheaton, Illinois. The center is Jeff Schmitz, a 6'2 freshman from Fenton, Missouri. Also in the middle is Ryan Clark, a 6'5 sophomore from Baldwin, Missouri. On the outside, it seems like he's been in Muncie forever, Mark Rumschick, 6'4 senior from Orchard Park, New York. The libero is Ian Peckler, 6'3 junior from Vernon Hills, Illinois. And on the outside is Matt Sprague, 6'4 freshman from Baldwin, Missouri. There you get a good look at the head coach of Ball State, Joe Walton, in his ninth year. His overall record, 154-82. Now the starters for the 10th-ranked Valley Dons of IPFW. The libero is Matt Pliske, a 6'3 freshman from St. Charles, Missouri. On the outside, C.J. Macias, the All-American 6'4 junior from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Also on the outside, Brock Ulrich, 6'6 junior from Winfield, Illinois. The center, one of the seniors, Cowan Lundeen, 6'3 out of Victoria, British Columbia. Getting a start tonight in the middle, another senior, Vitor Oliveira, 6'6 out of Caxias do Sul in Brazil. In the middle, 6'8 Josh Stewart, and he is a junior from St. Mary's, Ontario. And also on the outside, Jason Yost, 6'4 junior from San Diego, California. The head coach of IPFW in his 27th year, Arnie Baugh, and there you see 450 wins. That is the fourth most in NCAA Division I, 313 defeats. And as we said, Steve, Arnie is a graduate of Ball State, so it's always mixed emotions when the Dons and the Cardinals get together.
Well, don't let that fool you, though. You know who he wants to win. As a matter of fact, it's always like you want to beat where you were, so even though he graduated from there, it's all the more reason he wants to beat him, you know?
You're looking at a nice crowd here at the Hilliard Gates Sports Center for this matchup. Our officials tonight, the up official is Brian Himmelgarn, and the down official is Tom Joseph. Ball State will be wearing black uniforms, white trim, white numbering, white lettering. IPFW, white jerseys, blue trim, blue numbers, and blue shorts. In game one, the Dons will be going from left to right on your television screen. And again, Steve, as we said, a little bit of payback on the mind of IPFW because they did not like going down to Ball State on February 23rd, and as they felt, they were embarrassed losing 3-1.
Yeah, also in that match, Coach Ball had some troubles with the officiating, ended up getting ejected from one game, game four, I believe. So, you know, there's a lot to lot for the Dons to try and get back here. And what a better place to do it than here at the Gates Center. The crowd is huge already. And I bet you about 200 or 300 more people will be showing up in the next 5-10 minutes, usually how it goes.
IPFW won the toss. Jason Yost, the left-handed jump serve, and we are underway here at the Gates Center. Nick Meyer, and it's dug out by C.J. Macias. Josh Stewart, oh, nice block there at the net by Ball State. Another block, but it's a wide, and IPFW wins the first point of the match.
Well, setting the tone, both teams already putting up good blocks and taking good swings. This is going to be a good firefight tonight.
Jason Yost got into the lineup about 6-7 matches ago, and he has really played well, and it's a service ace.
Hey, oh, he's got that nice topspin jump serve. He really zips it. Gets a lot of topspin on it, so it looks like it's going to go out, but it dives down at the last moment and catches that end line.
We play rally point scoring in volleyball. Point scored on every serve. 2-0 IPFW on top. Ball State's going to try to get a defensive return over, so it's a free ball opportunity for IPFW.
Brock Ulrich, little dink shot, and it's good, and IPFW out on top 3-0.
It's a smart play by Brock Ulrich. You want to look to try and mix your attack up, sort of like a pitcher, throw a changeup, then a fastball, a couple fastballs, and another changeup. So it's a nice job. He's setting the tone early, throwing some off-speed stuff, if you will.
Good start thus far for IPFW, up 3-0. Yost with another strong jump serve. On the left side, Nick Meyer is blocked by Josh Stewart with help from Colin Lundin.
I like the way IPFW has come out tonight. There's no mistake that they're on a mission.
Timeout.
Doing everything right.
Timeout, Ball State. We'll take one as well. You're watching IPFW Volleyball on College 5 Sports.
What's up? The show's a 7. Whoa.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back, everybody. You see Don the Mastodon. Or is it Donette? I'm not sure, Steve.
No, that's Don.
You can tell me. The Volley Dons off to a great start, leading 4-0 here in game one of our best of five match. We mentioned earlier, rally point scoring in games 1, 2, 3, and 4. You played a 30, win by 2. If we have to go to a decided fifth game, it's played to 15 again, win by 2. Jason Yost will continue to serve for IPFW.
And that's a great serve.
Nick Meyer is going to set up Matt Sprague, and off the touch, Ball State gets their first point of the night.
Well, that's a really important kill for Ball State for two reasons. One, obviously, it stops the run IPFW was on. But two, it was a bad pass, and they were able to recover it and hit an out-of-system set, a set coming from way away from target.
Matt Sprague, freshman from Missouri, with the serve for the Cardinals. Here is Brock Ulrich. Nice dig that time by Ian Peckler. Ball State coming back. Pleske has a dig. And C.J. Macias mishit the ball into the top of the net, and Ball State has their second point.
Look tonight for this to be a trend. Great defense by Ball State. It's one of their staples.
Something else to look for, Steve. Joe Walton said they're going to try to double up, so to speak, on C.J. Macias, that being the Cardinals. Sprague long on the serve with a service error.
Well, what he meant by that was they're going to favor C.J. when he's attacking. They're going to maybe cheat out a little bit on him, maybe even try and get a triple on him. They're going to assume he's going to see the most sets, and it's a good assumption because he always does. So they're going to just try and prepare for that.
The corkscrew server, Brock Ulrich, dug out by Rumschick. Meyer unloaded. That didn't hit the net, Steve. That might have ended up back in Muncie.
You're right about that. Well, that looked like he missed by a lot, but actually he only missed by an inch because what he was trying to do is he was trying to hit the hands of the block because it wasn't a very good set and he didn't have much opportunity, so he tried to hit the hands of the block.
6-2, Bowie Don lead, and the Cardinals look a little disorganized at the moment. Free ball chance for IPFW. Oh, nice dig by Peckler de Libero. Nick Meyer, dig out by that time by Yost.
Good off-speed shot right there.
Meyer with a dig for Ball State. Sprague is blocked by Stewart. Point, IPFW. 7-2 our score. Again, we're in game one of our best of five match. IPFW looking for win number 17. Ball State looking for win number 15 here tonight.
And IPFW starting off with two big jump servers, really causing problems for Ball State. Except, you know, there.
Brock Ulrich commits the first Don service error of the night. 7-3 is our score. IPFW on top. Now we'll see the right-handed serve of Ryan Clark, a 6'5 sophomore, rather, from Baldwin, Missouri. Little float serve, and that handcuffs C.J. Macias. Free ball chance coming up for Ball State. Nice save that time by Yost. Set up, another dig by Jason Yost, and that time Josh Stewart mishit it.
Right, and I think that was a true mishit, unlike Meyer's, where Meyer was specifically trying to hit the hands of that block on the one that he sent sailing. I think Josh Stewart, that ball was just set past him and did all he could to get his hand on it.
Another serve for Clark. Ball State trailing 7-4, now make it 8-4 as that serve floats over the end line. Second service error on the part of Ball State here in game one. And now we'll see the 6'8 junior from suburban Toronto, Josh Stewart, serving for the first time tonight. A little float serve. McCarthy at the net, blocked by Macias. Meyer again, blocked by Oliveira. Are they going to call a net violation? Macias and Oliveira were both there near at the net, Steve.
I think that was called on Oliveira, and sometimes that happens when you make a block and you think the ball, you don't know where the ball went, and you turn to find it, you might rake the net with your arm or your shoulder.
Nick Meyer, 6'8 senior out of Cincinnati, twice this year has been the MIVA Player of the Week. Yost, and off the touch, the block is wide, and the point goes to IPFW.
It's real nice to have that left hand coming out of the right side. It's a more natural position for a lefty than it is for a righty, the right side.
Cowan Lundeen, one of the five Valley Don seniors, honored here tonight with the serve. Here's the setup for Rumschick, and it's wide. IPFW now leads 10-5.
Well, and here's the lineup change that you see across the front row for IPFW. You have Jason Yost, who has lately been playing right side, and now CJ, who's been a right side for a long time for IPFW, over on the left.
McCarthy, nice save that time by both Lundeen and Yost.
Here's a chance.
Lundeen for Oliveira, nice block at the net by McCarthy. Yost, and the block is wide, point Dons. Stick-to-itiveness that time for IPFW, Steve.
Yeah, Yost has two kills off the block, and I think he's gonna have a nice size block in front of him all night. He's got that left arm swinging cross court into the court, which is gonna get some nice angles off the block.
Lundeen serving, Don's up 11-5. Meyer, and the block, tag team block by Oliveira and Macias goes wide. Cardinals pick up a point.
Now one thing moving Macias onto the left side does is it gives a nice big old block on the left there. There, Meyer got a piece of it, but you'll see a lot more blocks coming off the left side now.
Clark, Ulrich, nice dig that time by Rumchick. IPFW wins the battle at the net. They're now up 12-6. Now we'll see some power. They're gonna give the point to a Ball State, Steve. They changed it.
Well, I'm not quite sure what the call was. It's possible that the libero dug the ball with his hands inside the 10-foot line. We're going to have to find out what that call was.
Well, it's now 11-7, Ball State trailing by four, but Mark Rumschick, 6'4 senior from Orchard Park, New York, continues to serve. Lundeen for Macias, and McCarthy blocks it.
Well, and there you have it. It looked like they were ready for that. They looked like McCarthy was cheating out a little bit towards CJ's side. CJ in this side out will be hitting from the right, and he'll probably stay, and Yost will stay on the left.
A little float serve by McCarthy. Oliveira, tip shot, kept alive by Schmitz. Sprague blocked at the net by Oliveira. The right side for Meyer, that's partially blocked. Lundeen for Yost on the right side, left side I should say, and Jason Yost with that left hand hammers it home.
Yeah, you know, the nice thing about the left hand is most teams don't have a whole lot of lefties. For IPFW, I believe Yost is the only lefty on IPFW, and so you don't practice it against it much, you don't see it in matches very much, and there is a difference.
Here's the jump serve by CJ Macias. Meyer on the right side, and it's long. 13-8 our score, Ball State trailing IPFW here in game one of our best of five match tonight. Glad you could join us here on College 5 Sports from the Hear Your Gate Sports Center. CJ Macias, a little bit wide on the serve, service error. Ball State now closest to within four, 13-9. And now we're gonna see Matt McCarthy, 6'8 sophomore out of suburban Chicago. High in the air with that toss. Lundeen gonna go left side for Ulrich. And Brock Ulrich comes through with his third kill of this first game.
It's a great angle he hit. He went inside the block, was able to get a good sharp angle. Really got over the top of the ball there.
Bowie Dons up 14-9. A little float serve for Vitor Oliveira.
It's a great serve.
Cross court Sprague. Lundin digs it out. Macias, little float shot. Schmitz, oh, Dons were awake at the net that time, and there's Stewart. Oh, nice dig by Pickler. Sprague on the left side, off the touch, point Ball State.
I'll tell you what, that was a phenomenal dig. That ball was down. You don't see many men's players able to dig a ball hit like that on that angle. That was about, I don't know, 5 feet in front of Pickler, so it was a nice pickup.
Freshman center Jeff Schmitz serving for Ball State. They're down 14-10, and I believe a lift is called. A double hit. So it's 14-11. The IPFW lead has been cut to three. Jump serve for Schmitz, and he hits it to cut the wind stream here at the Gate Center.
Well, I feel like Ball State service errors are sort of timely for IPFW because they always come on the heels of like a big play Ball State made or a lucky break, and then they go ahead and sort of kill their own luck.
Jason Yost, left-handed serve, dug out by Sprague. Oh, Stewart took advantage of that floating ball just over the net.
And then Ball State is continuing to struggle with the excellent serve of Jason Yost. One thing that's nice about that serve, like I said before, it comes in high, it looks like it's going deep and out, and then drops it on the end line, but hits the passers up by the shoulders. It's hard to pass.
Tough serve that time by Yost. Meyer from the left side.
Oh.
Off the forearm of Ulrich, and Ball State closes to within four. It's now 16-12.
And that is a tough angle he just hit. That's a tough angle to dig. It's also a tough angle to hit.
Nick Meyer now with three kills here in game one. Matt Sprague, freshman out of Missouri. Lundin gonna set up Macias. CJ came through with his first kill of the night.
That's a great swing, but a great set. The tempo of that set was perfect. You know, CJ didn't have to slow his approach down at all. He could fly right into it and stay in rhythm with the play. Really nice set by Lundin.
Brock Ulrich with that corkscrew serve. Pickler digs it out. Schmitz has got to go a long way to set up. Sprague gets it over.
Nice dig, but
Macias on the left side, and he mishit it.
Well, he didn't have a whole lot of places he could go with that ball. It was set way outside, and basically all he had was that cut shot. It's a hard shot to make, as I said a few plays ago. When Meyer hit that similar angle.
17-13, Ryan Clark with a lollipop float serve. Stewart, oh, Sprague with a big dig. Lundin gonna go right side for Yost. Whoa, Jason Yost whistled that one right off the forearm of Clark, and it's 18-13, IPFW.
And why I said before it's a good side for lefties, the right side, is because they're hitting shoulders on the inside of the court, so they can get to a lot more than a righty can, and vice versa on the outside. Yost is at a little bit of a disadvantage on the left.
Little lift action on the part of Ball State. IPFW comes up with another point.
Well, Schmitz looked like he slipped on something there, and it was a lucky break for IPFW.
Joe Walton calls his second allotted timeout, gives us a chance to invite you to join head coach Ernie Ball on College 5 for the Ernie Ball Show with highlights and perspective from the head coach and his guests. Host Mark Franke opens up the show. It's seen Wednesday evenings at 7:30, Fridays at 6:30, and Saturdays at 12:30 again. The Ernie Ball Show, catch it right here on College 5 Sports. Look at the hitting numbers. Neither team hitting very well, Steve. The Dons 185, Ball State 040.
You know, a couple players are having big matches right now. For example, Jason Yost playing right side, a position that's usually occupied by C.J. Macias. As a matter of fact, C.J. got his All-American award as a right side, so, you know, Jason Yost has got some big shoes to fill. Well, he's 4 out of 5, so he's hitting 800, and that's a huge key to the match right now. C.J. is hitting negative 333. He's got 1 kill, 3 errors, and 6 attacks, so Yost's sort of putting a team on his shoulders right now. On the other side of the court, Nick Meyer, the big gun for Ball State, he's hitting zero. So both teams' big guns are not hitting so well tonight so far. Meyer's got 3 kills, 3 errors on 9 attempts, so that puts him at zero. a hitting percentage is like batting average. You want to hit around 300. And so some role players are really making a difference right now for IPFW.
Josh Stewart will continue to serve for IPFW. That float serve into the backcourt. Schmidt from McCarthy. Oh, nice dig at the moment. Aldridge gets it over. Free ball chance for Ball State. Schmitz, left side for Rumchick, and off the touch. Cardinals get the point. That time a timeout worked well for Joel Walton.
Yes, it did. The nice thing is, you know, they're getting points by earning them out of timeouts rather than getting them from an error, which is a lot of times what happens at the timeouts, a service error or a silly play.
Nick Meyer with a deep serve. Oliveira past the diving Ian Pickler. Now 20-14 in favor of IPFW.
Now that's Oliveira's first kill, I believe. And although it's only his first kill, he's really causing a lot of trouble to the Cardinals because he keeps attacking and attacking. They have to pay attention to him.
Schmitz for Meyer, and Meyer comes through with his fourth kill of the night. Matt Plisky dove for it, but couldn't come up with it.
Look for Meyer to get a lot of swings out of the back row on the right side there. At IPFW, we call it a blue. It's just, that's the name of the set. Most teams call it a blue.
Rumchick just over the net with the serve. Lundin for Yost, left side, just inside the line. Perfectly placed shot by Jason Yost.
You know, I think he was going for hands on that. I think he was just trying to tip it off the block's hands and get a kill like that. The block, he missed the block, so I think he's, you know, he ended up with actually a better shot.
Just inside the line in the corner. Good serve by Macias. Schmitz and Ulrich at the net. And coming through with the kill that time is Matt Sprague, the freshman, and one of the Missouri boys, along with Ryan Clark. Ball State closing to within five. It's 21-16. Can we play to 30, win by two?
Schmitz was huge on that point, by the way. He had to go up for the joust and then have the presence of mind to turn, find the ball, and make a nice set.
Matt McCarthy with the serve for Ball State. Yost from the right side off the shoulder of Meyer. And a double hit, I think, is going to be called.
Yeah, that ball had a lot of spin on it, but it probably had some decent amount of sweat on it too, some moisture, because that dig seemed to roll a little bit up Meyer's chest and off his arms and everywhere else.
Jared Quillen in for Vitor Oliveira. Quillen, again, one of the five seniors honored here tonight from LaGrange, Ohio.
Hits a deep float, very hard to pass.
Hits the top of the net. Sprague keeps it alive. Right side for Meyer, Stewart, and Ulrich with the tag team block. Now the Cardinals go left, and again, IPFW blocks it. Meyer, defensive return. Free ball chance for IPFW.
It's got to be a better pass than that.
Yost off the touch. Clark tried to block it. It went into the stands, and IPFW now up 23-16.
Well, CJ missed the pass there. He pulled the setter away from target, but Lundin did a nice job of running and what we call it setting against the flow or setting against the grain. He was running forward but put the ball back and opened up a nice swing for Yost.
Schmitz to the left side for Sprague, and that's dug out by Quillen. Lundin going to set up Ulrich on the left side, and ball hung on the net for a moment. Schmitz to Sprague, left-handed shot, and just found the spot. Ulrich tried to get a pancake shot, save, a pancake dig, and couldn't do it.
Nice set by Schmitz. He saw some chaos on the Don side and got it out real quickly to the outside hitter. Dons couldn't reassemble their defense. It was a little chaotic, and it was a nice job of Ball State by taking advantage of that chaos.
Schmitz the setter with the serve. Lundin for Stewart. Oh, nice dig that time by Rumchick. Sprague off Lundin, and what's Cowan talking to Brian Himmelgard about?
Well, I think he wants them to ask the lines judge if the ball hit the antenna. If the ball hit the antenna, they would be out of bounds and it would be Ball State's ball. But the lines judge says no, it did not hit the antenna, so.
Okay.
A 23-18 IPFW lead. Jeff Schmitz, one of three. Players from Missouri on the floor for Ball State. Continues to serve. Tough serve that time. Lundin cross court to Yost, and that time the set wasn't the best.
Well, you know, the difficulty level of the set that Lundin just tried to make is sky high.
Well, Arnie Ball decides he wants to talk things over, and as we speak, he's talking to Jason Yost, a junior from San Diego. Again, our score right now is IPFW 23, Ball State 19. We're in game one of our best of five match tonight. Ball State comes into the Gate Center, ranked 15th in the country, 14-10 overall. And in conference play, they are 6-3. They're 4-7 away from the friendly confines of Worthen Arena. IPFW, on the other hand, 10th ranked in the country, 16-7 overall, 7-3 in MIVA action. And they are 8-3 in front of the home folks here at the Gate Center. One more home match for IPFW, and that'll be next Friday night against Rutgers Newark. And then, believe it or not, the regular season ends next Saturday when the Dons travel to Quincy for a rematch with the Hawks, who they defeated last weekend. And then the fun starts, Steve.
And
the MIVA tournament. Winner goes to Columbus to play for the NCAA championships in the Final Four. Schmitz serving after the timeout. Lundin for Ulrich. Wow, it brocked it up in the air.
That's a great play set coming out of the timeout. Couldn't be executed without the perfect pass, which there was a perfect pass, and it's a nice choice to go to the second hitter.
Oh, that was nice.
Yeah, the block bit for it, hook, line, and sinker. Big hole there for Ulrich to go after.
Good deep serve for Yost. Oh, look at that, Ulrich. The springs in his legs.
Yep.
Surprise Schmitz at the net.
You know, it's, Schmitz is a back row player, so he's not allowed to go up and try and block that. So Ulrich did a nice job of just pounding it and also being careful not to hit the net because it was sort of a tight overpass.
Schmitz to Clark. And Ryan Clark will come through with the kill, his first of the night. 25-20 our score, IPFW with the lead, Ball State with the serve. It'll be Matt Sprague, the 6'4 freshman out of Baldwin, Missouri. It's interesting, Steve, that Joe Walton got three players from the state of Missouri.
Well, they call that a pipeline. in recruiting terms, a lot of times if you can get one player from a club or a team or an area, it opens up what's called a pipeline where they, if they feed back to their teammates, they really like it there. Younger players come thereafter because they hear of the good experience your teammate is having.
Brock Ulrich with the serve. Dimes up by six. Rumschick, and he'll get credit for the kill as the block attempt by Stewart and Lundin goes wide. 26-21 our score. And coming in to serve will be Billy Ebo. He is a 6'3 freshman out of Lenexa, Kansas. Making his first appearance of the night for Ball State. Jump serve, dug out by C.J. Macias. Lundin high in the air for C.J. off the touch, point Dons.
Oh, there you see C.J. fighting.
That time.
Yep, fighting through the triple block. He deliberately made that shot. He swung across his body, was absolutely going for hands. Very smart play on CJ's part.
Dan McNerney comes in to serve, replacing Josh Stewart. McNerney is a 6'5 junior from Long Grove, Illinois. Looks over at the bench to see where they want him to serve it. 27-21, Don's up by six. Float serve just over the net. Schmitz for Meyer and off the touch. Ball State closes to within five.
And Meyer's heating up now. He's sort of found his rhythm, and that's trouble for the Dons.
Another substitution for Ball State. Ethan Feaster, 6'5 freshman from Shorewood, Wisconsin on the floor. Nick Meyer, the 6'8 senior from Cincinnati with the jump serve.
What a
serve.
That's a cross court, cut shot type jump serve. Most jump serves go real deep in a men's game. That's why you see them lining up just about 5 feet off the end line. And that one dropped just behind a 10-foot line.
But did it drop? Ball State within four. Macias on the left side, and it block is unsuccessful.
Again, here you have CJ hitting that hard angle, and a lot of times the deflection off the hard angle comes right back at you, and that would be out of bounds.
28-23 our score, Dons. 2 points away from a game one victory. Here's the set for Rumschick. Dug out by Lundin. Ulrich, yes! Pickler couldn't dig it out, and we have game point coming up for IPFW.
And those are the points that are going to make a difference all night, is when you can get Lundin to make a big dig like that, and then the libero of all people making a bump set, and you still get a kill out of that. It's not how it's supposed to work, but when you can make those plays work, I'll tell you what, those are the little points that make a big difference.
IPFW faithful on their feet. Lundin serving for game one. Hits the top of the net and dug out by Schmitz. Rumschick dug out by Plisky. Yost. Oh, and the Ball State stays alive. That ball, I think, hit the pole.
Yeah, hit the antenna. So it's Ball State's point. Again, the antenna's out of bounds. So it's just as though you're hitting the ball out of bounds and point for the other team.
Cardinals facing five game points. It's 29-24. Mark Rumschick to serve.
Nice pass.
Lundin for Macias. Game one to IPFW. CJ Macias with his fourth kill. And the Dons take the opening game of this match by a score of 30-24. We will take a break, catch our breath, and get ready for game two. You're watching IPFW Volleyball on College 5 Sports.
I've gone away to a college where the class size is small.
I've gone away to a college with a beautiful campus.
I've gone away to a college that cares about diversity.
I've gone away to a college where I get to live in my own apartment instead of living in a dorm room.
I've gone away to a college that really isn't that far away at all.
I go to IPFW.
IPFW.
I go to IPFW.
To find out more about college life at IPFW, go to our website. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
What's it like when you hear your calling? Will you remember where you were? Will you ignore it? Or will you listen? What if it calls you to go halfway around the world? To share your skills? To serve people you've never met. To do things you never thought you could. What will you do when you hear your calling? Peace Corps, life is calling. How far will you go?
Mom, Dad, you know we love kids, and I've made a decision that will totally change my life. Cameron's too. It's a huge responsibility, leading someone into, who knows, communication or science or math. That's what life's all about, right? Learning so you can pass on knowledge to younger minds. Dad, Mom, I want to be a teacher.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Hilliard Gates Sports Center here on the campus of IPFW, along with IPFW Women's Assistant Volleyball Coach DeFlorio. I'm Mike Maz. Game one of our best-of-five backyard brawl is in the books, featuring the 15th-ranked Cardinals of Ball State and the 10th-ranked Volley Dons of IPFW. Steve, we look at some of the numbers in game one. The Dons 18-14 lead in kills, 16-14 lead in assists, blocks even at one. Diggs favoring the home team, 16-13.
And that's a big stat right there, the Diggs stat, because it's really what Ball State does really well year in, year out is play defense. So when you can out-dig Ball State, you're in good shape. A couple other things to look at that aren't up on that screen is we sort of tagged two players from each team to be the go-to guys. And while Nick Myers turned it around, he had sort of a rough start. He had five kills, though. And Matt McCarthy, the other big gun for Ball State, only had one. Same on the IPFW side. Four kills for CJ, hitting just a 111 average. And Josh Stewart, the other big gun, one kill on eight swings. He's hitting zero. So what's happening is other players are picking up the slack. And Brock Ulrich has six kills, and he's hitting 500. And Jason Yost has six kills, and he's hitting 364 for IPFW. And right there, that's the difference, in my opinion, is the non-go-to players, if you will, are really picking up the slack.
Jeff Schmitz serving for Ball State to start game two. Schmitz with a big dig off of Jason Yost's kill attempt. Lundeen will set up Yost again, and net violation, or is it point IPFW?
Well, it's going to be a point IPFW because it was a net violation.
Okay. The thought was there, just came out garbage and scribbly, but it's 1-0 IPFW. And here is the aforementioned Jason Yost, Jr., from San Diego, California. Left-handed serve. And a lift. Nick Meyer was ready to unload, and they called the freshman setter Schmitz for a double hit. 2-0 our score here early in game two. IPFW going from right to left on your TV screen here in game two. Service error, the third service error of the night on IPFW. It's Ball State on the board.
And that's a big break for Ball State because all game one they struggled with Jason Yost's serve, so he sort of let him off the hook there. See if they can take advantage.
Sprague serving for the Cardinals. Lundeen setting up Macias, and it's wide. Ian Pickler, I should say, the libero for Ball State, let it go, and it was a wise decision. We're tied 2-2. Sprague, the 6'4 freshman, one of the three Missouri players on the floor for the Cardinals, continues to serve. It's the net. Lundeen's got to go a long ways for Ulrich. Dink shot! Pickler couldn't get to it, and the second time tonight, Brock Ulrich has pulled the string.
And Brock Ulrich is doing a great job of mixing those up. Like I said in the very beginning of the match, it's like a good pitcher just changing up his pitches, change up, fastball, change up, fastball. You know, you keep the defense hesitant. They're not sure of what type of shot you're going to hit next. They have to guess. They can't get in the comfort zone.
3-2 IPFW lead, Brock Ulrich. Out of Illinois with that corkscrew jump serve, and it's just a hair long.
And another break for Ball State because I think of all the servers that IPFW has, those are the two servers Ball State have struggled with the most tonight so far.
Second service error of the game, fourth service error of the match on IPFW. Macias, long.
So they got the triple block on Macias. He tries to go over the top that time and just an inch or two long.
4-3, Ball State lead. Ryan Clark will serve. Lundeen to Stewart.
And Stewart connects, and that's an important kill. They need to start getting Stewart more involved. They were trying earlier. He did have 8 swings, but he just wasn't connecting well. Lundeen needs to try and establish a connection because sooner or later, Ball State's going to start handling that outside attack.
Float serve by Josh Stewart. Schmitz setting up Runcheck. Yost couldn't stretch long enough, and Ball State retakes the lead 5-4.
That's a great shot by Runcheck. He's facing cross court, and he swings down the line across his body. It's very deceptive, and it catches the defense off guard a little bit.
Nick Meyer with a jump serve, and it's wide. Service error on the Cardinals. We're tied 5-5. Again, this is game two of our 5-game match. IPFW won game one, 30-24. And here is the Canadian, Colin Lundeen, and he returns the favor with a service error. Ball State up 6-5. Rumchick, 6'4 senior out of suburban Buffalo, New York. Backcourt float serve. Macias will dig it out.
Good pass.
CJ off the set, off the touch of Rumchick. Point IPFW, we're knotted again at 6.
You know, it's something CJ should be used to. Most teams do camp out on him. Most teams expect him to see the ball a lot more often than everyone else. And I'd like to see him go for hands more than he has tonight. His last couple errors, he could have probably hit hands and gotten kills.
Schmitz, right side for Meyer. And not the best of blocks by Oliveira and Ulrich. And again, the Cardinals retake the lead 7-6. Matt McCarthy to serve. McCarthy, 6'8", sophomore out of Wheaton, Illinois. That ball was very high in the air. And they're going to call Lundeen for a lift, I think.
No. What they're calling is a net violation. And Well, that was an interesting play because what they've been enforcing in the men's game is if the setter reaches over the net when he's back row and saves the ball from going over, but he reaches onto the opponent's side, they will call a back row attack on the setter. But there, the up official felt that the ball was still in the plane. In the same time, Ball State went ahead and tried to hit it and hit the net.
Oliveira with the dig. Here's Lundin, right side for Yost, and the left-hand shot of Jason Yost finds the mark, and IPFW takes their third lead of game two. It's now 8-7.
And he continues to stay hot, Yost. That's 8 kills on 14 swings. He's hitting 429.
Oh, miss hit on the serve by Oliveira. Another service error. The Dons have had more service errors this game than they did last game.
Yeah, they're not helping their own cause right now, but again, they're getting some great help from players that aren't typically expected to shoulder the load, so it's just going to make it that much easier for CJ to get his rhythm back.
Yost right off the hands of Schmitz. It's now 9-8, Bowie Dons on top. IPFW going more and more away from CJ Macias right now. As you said, Steve Florio, it seems to be working.
Yeah, it's great to have more options. It always is, isn't it? On a football team, if you got three great receivers, it's better than having two, you know? And it takes the heat. You know, basketball team, if you have three great scorers, it takes the heat off of your big guy.
We're tied at 9. Matt Sprague serving for Ball State. Service ace. The second ace of the night for the Cardinals. Nick Meyer had the other one in game one, and now the Cardinals have taken the lead, 10-9.
And let's face it, CJ's hitting 5 kills, 5 errors on 12 swings. He's hitting 0. But, you know, he'll find his way eventually, so it's nice that he doesn't have to rush to do it.
Ulrich and Clark couldn't block it cleanly, and we're knotted at 10. Back and forth we go here in game two. FW won game one, 30-24. We're tied at 10. And we have said this now for 3 years, Steve, the corkscrew-type serve of Brock Ulrich coming up.
It's hard to read, it's difficult to pass, and it comes over with a lot of velocity.
Schmitz setting up Runcik. Oh, what a block by Lundin at the net.
Wow, right there, that's one thing they're going to miss when Lundin leaves this team, is he is an uncanny blocker. I mean, as a setter, for him to be able to block as good as he does, that's just a bonus. And I've said this before, it's like having a catcher in baseball that's also a great hitter.
11-10, IPFW lead. Oh, nice short set by Schmitz, and Ryan Clark put it away.
Yeah, very quick offense there by Ball State. IPFW didn't even have a chance. They weren't even set. That's how fast it was. It was a well-run play.
Tied at 11. This is reminiscent of a heavyweight fight. Back and forth we go. Clark with the float serve, and it floats over the line. A Cardinal service error. So the Dons retake the lead, 12-11, and now let's see what Josh Stewart can do with his float serve. That's dug out by Pickler. Schmitz setting up Meyer. Oh, nice block. Oliveira and Macias were there.
If you've ever heard a coach say, turn the block in, there it is. That is a perfect example of redirecting the block, of angling the ball back towards the middle of the court. Textbook. Great, nice job by Macias.
A little daylight for the Dons. They're up 13-11. Meyer showing why he's the go-to guy for Ball State. Comes through with his 7th kill of the night.
And again, you know, Meyer's got 7 kills, but he's got 4 errors. So he really hasn't helped his team a whole lot. Same with Macias. So again, it's really coming down to whose role players are playing better.
Lundin gonna go to the right side for Yost. Oh, Runcik and McCarthy were there. And they thwarted Yost, and we're tied at 13.
And it looks like Rumchick's getting a little more used to getting a block on that lefty. He's finally started to step in more into the court because of course his left shoulder is on the inside of the court, so gotta make that adjustment.
Good serve. Ulrich dug out by.
Good swing.
Sprague, here's Rumchik.
Threads the needle there, goes sort of through the block, over the block, finds that corner. It's a nice swing, but it was a great swing by Ulrich from the set coming from about 25 feet off the net.
Mark Rumchick now with four kills, and Ball State retakes the lead 14-13. They're on a roll. They've won the last 3 points. Lundin going to go left side for Macias. Oh, yes.
And there he goes over the top. And that's a mismatch. You got big jumping Macias hitting over the small setter for Ball State, Jeff Schmitz. And look for IPFW to try and exploit that more often tonight.
14 all. Cowan Lundin with the jump serve. Sprague digs it out. Paddle at the net. And that hit the pole. Who gets the point?
They're going to give the point to IPFW.
And we have a timeout on the floor. 15-14, Valley Dons lead. You're watching IPFW Volleyball on College 5 Sports.
Master's degree from IPFW, it could be even better. You could land a promotion, earn more money, become a leader in your field. And IPFW makes it easy. With affordable tuition, night and weekend classes, and more than 20 graduate programs from business to education to public affairs and more. Become the master of your future. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne, your graduate university.
Steve Florio, tell us what's transpired here.
Well, you're looking at a nice jump serve by Lundin. And what's happening there is it was a tough pass, tough set, and tipped into the antenna. Very simple. Point IPFW. Again, the ball can't hit the antenna.
Valley Dons lead 15-14 here in game two. They won game one 30-24, trying to avenge a 3-1 defeat down in Muncie back on February 23rd. And a victory by the 10th ranked team of the country would strengthen their hold on second place in the MIVA. With one more conference match to go next Saturday night at Quincy. Cowan Lundin continues to serve. McCarthy, nice dig by Ulrich.
That's an important play. See if the Dons can get a hold of it now.
Schmitz went offensively. Faked the set to McCarthy and hammers it home. That's his first kill of the night, and we're tied again, this time at 15 apiece. Substitution. Todd Chamberlain, number 11, 6'2" sophomore out of Louisville, Kentucky.
Well, even though the Dons aren't winning those points, they're making Ball State earn them. By playing good defense, Ball State's got to put the ball away, and that's going to take its toll as the match wears on.
Rumchick serving for the Cardinals. Nice dig by Meyer. Gets the top of the net. Lundin, again for Oliveira. And the Cardinals somehow, with the help of the net, keep it alive. Yo says, no more, Ball State. Take that. And IPFW goes up 16-15.
What a great swing by Yost down the line. It's a bit of a tough swing because you got to sort of open your hips up and swing away from your body as a lefty. And if you're on the right side, you got to do that same as a righty.
The jump server, C.J. Macias, hits the net. Pickler digs it out. McCarthy wide. And IPFW goes up to 17-15. Steve, last week we did the matches on the internet, and Arnie Ball told us that the trip to California really helped Jason Yost playing at home, and he's been playing with confidence ever since.
Oh, yeah, and it's going to make IPFW so much tougher to beat come tourney time.
Miss hit by McCarthy, and now it's a 3-point Valley Don lead.
We'll talk more about Yost in the break, but he's going to be a key to the run the Dons can possibly make into the Final Four.
Macias jump serve. Schmitz tries to go offensive again, but Macias will dig it out. Ulrich from the left side, and the block is wide. Block, they turned out instead of in, Steve.
Right. They need to see that video on CJ.
And Joel Walton says enough is enough. He wants to call a timeout. Gives us a chance to tell you that for tickets to IPFW athletic events, get on the phone, call 260-481-6000, or go to the IPFW athletics website, www.gomastodons.com. Tickets are available yet for individual events. Again, the phone number, 260-481-6000, or online, gomastodons.com. And if you see there, discounts for Royal Dons Club members. Well, IPFW up 19-15. We look at the hitting numbers. 389 for IPFW in game two, 063 for Ball State.
And again, the I don't want it to sound like a not an important term when I say role players, but when you think of IPFW and offense, you think of C.J. Macias and Josh Stewart. And when you think of Ball State offense, you definitely think of Nick Myers, the first thing I think of. So Nick Myers not really getting it done, so to speak, for Ball State. CJ's not necessarily getting it done for IPFW. So what it comes down to is which supporting cast is going to play better. And right now, it's clearly IPFW. Jason Yost, Brock Ulrich.
C.J. Macias, service error. That's twice tonight. Joel Walton has called a timeout, and the Cardinals have gotten the point off the timeout.
You know, but it's as far as I can remember, it's the first time that IPFW just handed it right over with the service error.
McCarthy with a jump serve.
Good pass.
Ulrich from the left side, and Clark's block is wide.
That's
20 to 16,
that's
IPFW.
Something Ball State needs to fix is they need to start turning their blocks in. They've gotten tooled an awful lot tonight. For every block they have, they're probably getting tooled three or four times.
Jared Quillen coming in for Vitor Oliveira.
Again, Jared hits that deep float serve. It moves a lot. It's a lot like a knuckleball in baseball. It's very hard to pick up.
The Valley Down advantage is 4-20 to 16. We're in game two. IPFW won game one, 30 to 24. There is that knuckleball serve. And a miss hit by Chamberlain. Of course, looking at 6'8" Josh Stewart across the net might have scared him a little bit.
Well, he tried for what's called a 4-4 cut shot. And it's a very hard shot to hit. I thought he was up high enough to get it, but he tried too hard to cut it.
Look at that ball float over. Schmitz, left side for Chamberlain. And that time, Chamberlain, he made amends.
Yep, yeah. Looks like he had something to say through the net, too. And that doesn't surprise me. It gets heated out there between Ball State and IPFW.
Yeah, the two schools roughly 85 miles apart on I-69. Schmitz with the jump serve. Lundin, a high set for Ulrich. And Rumchick couldn't dig it properly. And IPFW now up by 5, 22-17.
We've got Brock Ulrich with 11 kills, Jason Yost with 10. CJ doesn't have to do anything. It's sort of nice.
I wouldn't go that far, but they may be saving him for down the road.
Well, you know, if he's having an off night, it's nice to know that there's other players that can take it for him.
It's going to be a free ball chance for the Dons. Lundin, though, has to go a long way, and Ball State's going to come away with the point, I believe. Lundin charged with a double hit, and there's a point wasted by IPFW.
Yes, that was an opportunity that the sort of let go with their ball control.
So here's the sophomore from Louisville, Todd Chamberlain with the jump serve. Pliski will dig it out. Lundin to the right side for Yost. Ooh, good save by Lundin. Ulrich, Pickler with the dig. Meyer at the right side, and Ulrich keeps it alive. Free ball chance for Ball State. Meyer wide, the Dons dodge a bullet.
And those points right there where you fight for them, you fight for them, you fight for them, you don't give up on them. They're called scrappy points. And they, like I said earlier, they take a toll on a team. You think, what do we got to do to put this ball away? What do we got to do to finish the point? And then you end up trying to do too much. Like Meyer there tried to slam it down the line and just missed.
23-18, IPFW with the lead, Ulrich with the serve. Schmitz to McCarthy, and I think the block. Good, wide.
Blocked out of bounds.
Tom Joseph, the Don official, talking to the Cardinals. And looks like Ball State's going to get the point. Billy Ebel is going to check back in for Ryan Clark.
And just to finish my point is those scrappy points where even if you don't win them, but you make them into long rallies, it just lets the other team know you got to work harder if you're going to want to get some points out of us.
Ebel high in the air with the jump serve into the net and backwards. Sometimes server's worst nightmare is that service error. Oliveira and Dan McNoney back on the floor for IPFW. They're up 24-19 here in game two. after having won game 130-24. Clark going to come back in for Ball State for Ebel. And let's see what Dan McNooney can do with the serve.
Quirky float serve.
Schmitz to McCarthy. Oh, what a save by McNooney for the moment, but his teammates couldn't catch up to it. McCarthy to get credit for the kill, just his second of the night. But it pulls Ball State to within four, 24-20. It's a pivotal time here, Steve. IPFW up by four, but you don't want to get into a side-out game, so to speak, because the team can get off on a run. Ball State's not 15th ranked in the country for nothing.
And you see Ball State made a sub there. They took their setter out, Jeff Schmitz. They went ahead and put Ethan
Feaster
in.
Second time tonight
and,
they've done that.
Yeah, he's a freshman setter, same as Jeff Schmitz. Looks like he's a bigger blocker, though, and that could be what they're going for right now.
Macias, and McCarthy's block is wide. IPFW up 25-21.
And Feaster's going to stay in and set the offense. So it was a little more than a blocking sub. It was just an offensive change.
Wow, big serve. Yost, oh, nice dig by Rumchick. And it goes into the stands. Great effort by Feaster. But now the lead is up to five, 26-21.
And IPFW has just been serving very, very tough tonight.
Lundeen. Wow, that knocked Chamberlain down. Meyer, Lundeen with a dig. Left side for CJ. Oh, Ball State on the reflex. As Feaster hit it, came right back at Macias, and CJ couldn't do anything about it.
You know, and on other nights, you know, CJ might have to worry, because if he's having an off night, it's sort of trouble for the Dons. But he's got his teammates supporting him with excellent play, and so he can just relax and try and find his groove and not feel the pressure.
Pickler digs out the Yost kill attempt. Here's Meyer from the right side. Lundeen high in the air for Ulrich. The dink shot. Pickler with the dig. Meyer again. Now Ball State is getting some confidence. They're down 26-23, and Ernie Ball's going to want to talk things over. Momentum's such a big thing, Steve Florio. When you have it, it's great, and when you lose it, it can be a nightmare.
And it's a big thing in this sport. I mean, you ask anybody who plays or coaches, and they'll tell you it's real, and it exists, and it's the momentum. And so that's a great timeout by Coach Ball. Doesn't want it to build up too much for Ball State. Wants to put a stop to it right now with some room to spare. So
I have to ask you, Steve, when a timeout is called like this, how much of the timeout is used in talking to your team, and how much is just to kill time and hopefully throw your opponent off kilter and off their rhythm?
You use the entire time to talk to your team. You talk over what's going right and what needs to be fixed. And at the same time, you're hoping the other team sort of loses their rhythm a little bit and that momentum slows down. So it's for both purposes, but you just don't call a timeout and let your team just sort of sit there. You definitely go find something to talk about. Because obviously, if there's the other team's on a run, something's not working right.
And there you see a replay of that point where
the tough serving by IPFW forced an overpass and Yost put it away.
Well, Mark Rumchick will continue to serve for Ball State. They're down 26-23 as play resumes. A little knuckle float serve. Short set, and McCarthy comes up with a block, but Yost says, take that, Ball State, from the right left side into the right corner.
And Yost, that's his 12th kill of the night, followed closely behind by Brock Ulrich.
Rhythmic chant in the background here at the Gate Center. Dons up 27-23. Macias, jump serve, chance for IPFW. Yost says hello. And it was a serve that set up the point, Steve.
That's right. Again, it's the extremely tough serving of IPFW that's forcing a lot of tough passes by the typically extremely great ball control team in Ball State.
Well, Joel Walton calls his second and final allotted timeout. You're looking at Ernie Ball talking with Jason Yost. And,
well, you know,
back and forth we go.
Yeah, and that was a great timeout 2 points ago by Coach Ball, because it allowed, it did indeed stop the momentum. It got IPFW back on the right track.
As we see another replay here tonight, thanks to the guys back.
And a heads-up play by Yost. I mean, he was moving into cover and saw that ball up to hit and got off the ground quickly and made a quick pull on it. It's a nice job. He's having a great match tonight.
Now, again, this regular season winding down for both teams. After tonight, IPFW will play Rutgers-Newark next Friday night here at the Gates Center and then turn around and make the, I think, about a seven-hour drive to Quincy, Illinois to take on the Hawks next Saturday night. The task a little bit tougher for Ball State. They've got to take on, I believe it's Lewis University and Ohio State next weekend.
Now, Ohio State is strong this year, very strong.
Well, they lead the conference. Macias, the jump serve, Don's 2 points away from taking a 2-0 lead. And off the touch, the Cardinals claw their way back.
Both teams have been real effective out of timeouts, so that's a good sign for both teams.
McCarthy will serve it up for Ball State. His team trailing IPFW 28-24. Yost, oh, that time Clark and Chamberlain were waiting for Jason Yost.
Yeah, he didn't have a whole lot of places to go with that ball. He didn't even really have a tool shot there. It was a sort of a tight set, and they were lined up on him properly on his cross-court angle.
Big serve, big point here. McCarthy high in the air. Pliskio dig it out. Lundeen left side for Ulrich. Blocked. Omasius with a reflex save. Meyer from the right side. It's wide, and IPFW has game point.
Now, one change Ball State has made is they are blocking more balls in. They're not getting tooled as much, so it's a good change. Might be too little too late for this game, though.
Game point. Vitor Oliveira will throw it up. IPFW fans on their feet. The float serve. Lundeen with the dig. Yost is going to play the center for Ulrich. Nice save.
What a cover by Lundeen.
Tip of the net. Pickler with the dig at the net. Who's got it? Still alive. Oh, Stewart! Those long arms. IPFW prevails 30-25. How nice is it to have a wingspan?
Yeah, I'll say.
IPFW wins game 2, 30-25. They now have taken a commanding 2-0 lead. The mandatory 10-minute timeout coming up next. We'll take a break. You're watching IPFW Volleyball.
IPFW's mastodons on parade were a big hit when the unique creations roamed the streets of Fort Wayne. A series of miniature mastodons will be offered to the public later this year, and you get to decide which ones will make the cut. Go to ipfwmastodons.org, click on the Mastodon Collectibles link, and pick your favorite. Voting runs from Monday, April 9th through Friday, April 20th. The top mastodon will be announced April 25th. Go to ipfwmastodons.org and vote for your favorite mastodon collectible.
Parents, there's something you can do to protect your kids from drugs and alcohol. Combine ground beef with egg, tomato sauce, breadcrumbs, and spices. Bake in an oven-safe pan at 350 for 50 minutes. Serve hot.
This is Jamie Lee Curtis. Children who eat dinner with their families are less likely to smoke, drink, or use drugs. So, have dinner together every day.
Delicious.
A message from CASA, the National Center on Addiction and Substance Abuse at Columbia University.
Warning, ruthless invaders are among us, and the future of fishing depends on stopping them dead. Only you can prevent invasive species from spreading before it's too late. Inspect, clean, and drain your boat, motor, and live wells, and properly dispose of invasive species on land, not back in the water. Stop these evil menaces from taking over and threatening our precious outdoor heritage. Inspect, clean, and drain. Do your part to halt the silent invasion.
Do you have everything you need? Paper, pencils?
We only ask that you do your best.
I made you a snack.
Um.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Hillier Gate Sports Center here on the campus of IPFW. We are in the 10-minute break between games 2 and 3 of our match featuring nationally ranked teams. The 10th-ranked IPFW Valley Dons have won games 1 and 2 over the 15th-ranked Ball State Cardinals. Game 1 score 30-24, game 2 score 30-25. I'm Mike Maas, joined by IPFW Women's Assistant Volleyball Coach Steve Florio. And Steve, your initial thoughts on the first two games of this match thus far?
Well, my initial thoughts are the guys that aren't supposed to be the guys are the guys, if that makes any sense.
You were an English major in school.
You know, you've got Brock Ulrich and Jason Yost for IPFW just tearing it up right now. Jason Yost, 13 kills on 23 swings. That's 391 percentage. That's like a batting average, so imagine a baseball player hitting 391. That's great. But even better, Brock Ulrich, 11 kills on 23 swings. So that means he's hitting 478. So imagine that in baseball terms. And again, I've been saying all game, I probably sound like a broken record. You know, you've got your big gun, CJ Macias and Josh Stewart. They're having off nights. They're really not getting it done. But that's okay right now because it's two other players really getting it done. And the difference in the match is that you got Nick Meyer and Matt McCarthy, who are the big guns for Ball State, and they're not really getting it done. Nick Meyer hitting 0.08% on the night. That's, put that in batting average terms, not very good. And then Matt McCarthy just hitting 100. So both the big guns for Ball State not really getting it done. And then there's no one else after that. After those two guys, no one else on Ball State's getting it done. The next closest guy in kills is Matt Sprague. He's got 5. So there's a difference in the match. Also, ball control for IPFW, very solid. Ball control for Ball State, not so good. And that right there is probably related to the offense. And then defense, you got 26 digs for IPFW and only 23 for Ball State. And again, when you can out-dig and out-ball control Ball State, you're in business because that's their bread and butter, is their ball control.
Let's stay with the sport of volleyball but change genders for a moment, as we've told our viewers tonight.
I'll try.
You are Kelly Hartley Hutton's right-hand guy, so to speak, assistant coach for the women's volleyball team, and independent champions and in the past, and now you've got this nice little carrot in front of you as starting in late August, early September, the Mid-Continent Conference title will be up for grabs, and that's got to be awfully exciting for you and Kelly, the staff, and the team.
Yeah, it's exciting for the team. It's exciting for us. It's exciting for the university. I mean, here we are, pretty much one of the only teams that's been able to compete for a Division I conference championship has been the men's volleyball team. So now every team gets that feel of going for it at the end of the season, having something to play for, and that's something we haven't had as a Division I program. Certainly when we were Division II, we all knew how that felt, but these are new players. None of them were here when we were Division II for every team, not just women's volleyball. So it's an exciting time for all the teams and for the university. Finally, the university can get behind all the sports and root them on into the NCAA tournament.
And that's the key. The NCAA tournament is that big carrot we're talking about. Can you tell our viewers who some of the opponents, not counting the conference matches, but who some of the non-conference opponents may be this fall?
Well, you know, what we're looking at is looking at some really tough opponents on the road. Straight off the bat, we're going to see Bowling Green, who handled us really well last year, and they're just red hot right now, second best team in the MAC. We're going to come right up against Dayton, who's always a very tough opponent. In our conference schedule, we're also gonna see University of Illinois in the first weekend. So we're sort of in for it on the first weekend. We're gonna do our very best, and I bet we can come out in good standing out of that first weekend because we got some nice players coming in. In conference, joining us from the independent ranks will be North Dakota and South Dakota State, and we're not too crazy about that because they always give us a tough time. Also, you're gonna have Oral Roberts, who is always first or second in the mid-con. So for the three of us, North Dakota State, South Dakota State, and IPFW, we're new kids on the block, and we're going to look to make some waves in there.
Yeah, a little party crashing, so to speak. We will take a break. Again, IPFW leading Ball State 2-0. Back with some composite numbers and game 3 in a moment. You are watching IPFW volleyball, that is, right here on College 5 Sports.
We all want the same thing.
Peace.
And Rotary Clubs are making it happen. Through international scholarships for young people to promote peace and understanding around the world. Rotary. Humanity in motion.
Pizza!
Pizza!
Oh, I must eat. Wait, what is this? Capsicum annuum? Agaricus bisporus? Allium sepa?
Can we eat this?
Peppers, mushrooms, and onions? Eat your pizza, man.
Funny.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Diabetes is a killer. After I was diagnosed, I didn't feel sick, so I didn't listen to my doctor. Then it struck. I had a heart attack, then a stroke, and I was only 49.
People with diabetes are 2 to 4 times more likely to suffer a stroke than people without diabetes. And many who survive are severely disabled.
Don't let diabetes destroy your life.
Learn how to reduce your risk of stroke. Call for your free diabetes survival guide.
IPFW's Mastodons on Parade were a big hit when the unique creations roamed the streets of Fort Wayne. A series of miniature mastodons will be offered to the public later this year, and you get to decide which ones will make the cut. Go to IPFWMastodons.org, click on the Mastodon Collectibles link, and pick your favorite. Voting runs from Monday, April 9th through Friday, April 20th. The top mastodon will be announced April 25th. Go to IPFWMastodons.org and vote for your favorite mastodon collectible.
Back at the Gate Center, IPFW up 2-0 on Ball State. Steve Florio, when we look at the numbers, they all seem to favor the home team tonight, the IPFW Valley Dons.
Yeah, well, again, the big number to look at, two of them, is the hitting percentage. I mean, absolutely out-hitting them, 29.5 to 16.2. Again, just always think of it in terms of batting average in baseball, and it makes it a lot easier to understand. It's basically IPFW's hitting about 300. Mm-hmm. And
I've gone away to a college where the class size is small.
I've gone away to a college. Never fly, so it's not flying here either. And the other stat is the digs. IPFW is out ball controlling Ball State, and again, that is Ball State's bread and butter, is their ball control. And without it, they're not as strong.
IPFW will serve it up first here in Game 3, and they'll be going from left to right on your television screen. Again, the Dons ranked 10th in the country. 7-3 in MIVA play. They trail the Ohio State Buckeyes. And Ball State is 6-3. And they not only trail Ohio State and IPFW, but they trail Loyola of Chicago as well.
You know, and IPFW started the season out red hot. I mean, sweeping Penn State, beating Stanford both nights. You know,
they won their first eight matches of the year.
Yeah, you know, beating Loyola twice in 5. I mean, they start out red hot, and then, you know, they started to stumble a little bit. Ohio State came to town. They didn't have quite as much firepower as those teams. Teams started to lean on C.J. Macias, and looked like IPFW was just stumbling a little bit and not falling out of their groove. And actually, what we have here is we might have a replay. But anyway, and then along comes Jason Yost, as you see him serving and causing more trouble, causing another overpass.
And his opposite setter, Jeff Schmitz, was wide on the attempt. I know you wanted to talk about Jason Yost, the transfer from San Diego.
Yeah, that's right. And it's just an interesting situation for the Dons because, you know, little people don't really know this, but Coach Ball's been trying to get CJ on the outside, but he's never been able to find somebody to get on the right side that could fill that hole. And along comes Jason Yost. And talking to Jason, he's just explained to me and to a lot of people that, you know, he didn't really play in the fall in college and hadn't played a collegiate season in quite some time and was just a little rusty. And he was happy to get back into the game, and he just needed to shake off the rust. So he didn't, you know, although he got here in January, he didn't really surface till about the end of February, early March, because he was sort of getting back into volleyball shape.
Service error by Jeff Schmitz. That's the eighth service error of the night on the part of the Cardinals. We are tied 2-2 here in game three. IPFW opened the match 2-0. And now we will see the corkscrew type serve of Brock Ulrich. Schmitz.
Another tough pass.
Meyer, nice.
Nice dig by Yost.
Oh, miscommunication. Plisky, Macias, and Stewart all looked at each other. The result is a Cardinal point. They're up 3-2.
And that's a good break for the Cardinals.
Mark Rumchick will serve. Cardinals can freewheel it because they're down 2-0 in the games. Yost, wow. Rumchick kept it alive. Free ball chance coming up. Boom. Point as Pickler's defensive return was wide.
And you know, Ball State just gives it right back with a silly hitting error like that. So it sort of washes that miscommunication. Well, back to Yost real quickly. You know, in volleyball, your outside hitters are sort of the guys that get leaned on night in, night out, because they're the easiest guys to get the ball to. So they tend to get the most sets and sort of have to carry a team.
Chamberlain.
Now, what does this have to do with Yost? What does the outside hitters have to do with Yost? And the thing is Coach Ball's been wanting to get CJ his big gun on the outside, but he's never been able to do that. Now you're able to get CJ on the outside, tighten up what was a somewhat shaky outside attack for IPFW, and still go with a strong attack from the right side. So all in all, it bolsters the offense for IPFW and makes him, in my opinion, very, very dangerous coming into the postseason.
Josh Stewart commits the ninth service error for IPFW. We're tied 4-4. Lundeen, right side for Yost. And it's going to come right over your head, Steve.
Another big swing by Yost.
Jason Yost now taking a look. He's got 14 kills.
And again, Yost Ulrich taking the heat off Macias. Macias is having an off night, and he can. And that's the other thing. Coach Walton said he was going to key on Macias, and he has. He's kept Macias down, but he's allowed other players to go after it.
A little heat on Ball State that time. I think Meyer's going to get credit for the kill. We're tied 5-5 in game three. We haven't brought it up yet, Steve, but when we talked about it in the past, when a team is up 2-0, sometimes there's a letdown in game three.
Well, absolutely. You get comfortable. You feel safe with that two game to none lead, and then you sort of let your guard down a little bit.
Nick Meyer, the senior from Cincinnati, with the serve, and Chamberlain had it handed to him at the front of the net, and he put it away, and Ball State's up 6-5.
And what's been working so well for IPFW is sort of breaking down right now, and that's their serve receive and their ball control.
Meyer with the jump serve into the net.
And just when IPFW's ball control is breaking down, Ball State goes ahead and misses a serve. So another timely error in the favor of IPFW.
Tied 6-6, CJ Macias to serve. And again, tit for tat, so to speak.
Yep. You know, I'm looking out on the court right now and I'm seeing CJ, and you know, he looks, every now and then you can see some frustration on his face. And what he has to realize now is he can relax a little bit and just take his time and get his groove back. He's got other players, you know, shouldering the load.
Ulrich, a nice dig that time by Chamberlain. Lundeen gonna go right side for Yost. Meyer, McCarthy with the block at the net. Ulrich again. Now that hit Schmitz and in the post.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Off the block, into the antenna, nice tool kill. And at the end of game two, Ball State seemed to have solved that problem of not getting tooled so easily, not getting the ball hit off their hands and out of bounds so easily. But it looks like IPFW is right back at it.
Schmitz for McCarthy, it's a short set. How many times, and of course you being a coach, you've seen it very, very often, that short set seems to work wonders.
Well, you know, it's fast, it catches the defense off guard, and that's the whole purpose of it.
Here is Matt McCarthy, 6'8", sophomore out of Wheaton, Illinois. Jump serve. Macias with the dig.
Lundeen,
mistiming the jump was Josh Stewart. A little bit of daylight for the Ball State Cardinals. They now lead 9-7.
And Stewart and Lundin haven't, they just haven't been connecting well tonight.
McCarthy will continue to serve. Cardinals going from right to left here in game three. And it's a little bit strong, the serve of Matt McCarthy.
And another service error on the heels of a IPFW unforced error.
And now we'll see the left-handed serve, the jump serve of Jason Yost. Oh, how many times have we seen that, Steve? One team throws it, serves it into the net, and the other team can't take advantage because they do the same thing.
Yeah.
10-8 our score, Ball State on top. Jeff Schmitz gets it over the net. Let's see what Lundin does. Goes right side to Yost. Nice dig by Chamberlain. Rumchick.
Nice dig.
Dug out by Jason Yost. Macias.
And there's Macias. And see, he can just sit back and relax, and he doesn't have to feel the pressure of having to get every single kill. And it's something, you know, maybe he's almost at this point trained to feel that.
You get
because
the feel
that's how it's been.
You get the feel that Jeff Schmitz is going to have a little welt on his left forearm tonight after that shot?
He did unload. He did unload. Again, great tempo with that set from Lundin to Macias.
Brock Ulrich with a good serve at the net. Macias ties it up at the 10.
And don't look now, but someone's heating up.
Mr. Ulrich, and we've seen him in the past run off 6, 7, 8, 9 points in a row on a serve.
Macias getting 2 big kills in a row. Looks like he's getting his confidence back. That's trouble. That's big trouble for Ball State.
Wow, what a serve by Brock Ulrich. The fans here that like IPFW are loving it.
And you know what? You talk about momentum. I hear you say it all the time, and here it goes. You know, can you feel it? I mean, a couple big serves, and all of a sudden the energy's back on IPFW's side.
Ball State calls a timeout. We'll take one as well. You're watching IPFW Volleyball on College 5 Sports.
Size is small.
I've gone away to a college with a beautiful campus.
I've gone away to a college that cares about diversity.
I've gone away to a college where I get to live in my own apartment instead of living in a dorm room.
I've gone away to a college that really isn't that far away at all.
I go to IPFW.
IPFW.
I go to IPFW.
To find out more about college life at IPFW, go to our website. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back, everybody, to a noisy Hilliard Gates Sports Center here on the campus of IPFW. The 10th-ranked Valley Dons lead Ball State, ranked 15th in the country, 11-10 here in Game 3. IPFW up 2-0 in this best-of-5 match. And in Game 4, Steve Florio, IPFW right now hitting .444, Ball State just .100.
One of the keys to that hitting percentage is the tough serving of Ulrich and the other Dons just getting the ball back easily for IPFW, and then they're able to run basically right in system. And in system in volleyball terms means that the setter's setting right from where he wants to be, and he has all his options. He can set any hitter he wants.
Ulrich got a break, and Meyer hit it too hard. Ball State screaming for a touch. Meyer talking to Brian Himmelgarn, our up official tonight. Meyer being the captain for the Cardinals.
Again, like you said, they're asking, wasn't there a touch? If the line judge doesn't call it and the up official doesn't see it, simple, you can't call it.
Ball State head coach Joe Walton talking to the down official Tom Joseph for a moment, but the point stands 12-10 Valley Dons, and Ulrich continues to serve.
Wow.
What a serve. And Clark will get the kill off the touch. Boy, when a ball comes at you that hard and dips, it's awfully hard to return it.
Oh, yeah. That was a good pass because that was a good serve.
Talk about having mustard on a hot dog. Float serve. Macias.
Okay.
Gets into double figures
back
with his 10th kill of the night.
And that's what he's capable of. I mean, he still is the guy, you know. He is capable of hits like that. And, you know, every great player can slump a little bit here and there, so it's nice when you got other players that can shoulder the load while you're just trying to get your groove back. Well, guess what? His groove's back. That's trouble for Ball State.
And Nick Meyer
Again,
hit that into the stratosphere.
Again, Meyer didn't have anywhere to go with that shot, so what he was trying to do was hit the block again. And Macias wisely didn't even jump this time. He didn't even give him hands to hit.
14-11, IPFW lead. Stewart with that jump float serve. And that time, Rumchick and Pickler, the libero, collided.
And if you can see the faces on Ball State right now, the wind is out of their sails.
But we are only midway through this third game. It is 15-11, IPFW. Again, we played a 30, win by two in games one, two, three, if need be, four. Schmitz, left side feed for Matt Sprague, and Sprague comes through with his sixth kill of the night. Stops the bleeding at least momentarily for the Ball State Cardinals. It's now 15-12.
Now IPFW needs to use their good ball control that they've had tonight to get this ball right back and hold on to the momentum.
Lundin for Oliveira off the left fist of Clark. 16-12.
And IPFW. Back goes another tough jump server for IPFW now. See if they can keep the heat on.
Cowan Lundin, the senior from Victoria, British Columbia, will throw it up. A service ace! And you're right, the pep is out of the step of Ball State. Mighty Moore wearing blue and white. Chamberlain will come in, so Joel Walton doesn't have to use a timeout, replacing Sprague.
And Coach Walton looking for some answers, you know. It's 17-12, they're not out of this game, but they feel like they are, and that's what counts right now.
Serve just inside the line by Lundin. He goes to the center of the court. And a lift gonna be charged to the Ball State center, Jeff Schmitz. And the ball's coming right at us, Steve.
You know, and a lot of times now you see Ball State questioning every call. They're looking for points any way they can. They're frustrated.
Now they've just used up their second and final allotted timeout here in game three. As you look at the ninth year head coach of Ball State, Joel Walton, who played collegiately at Ball State. And gives us a chance to let you know that the latest Mastodon scores and stats are always available on the World Wide Web. Just go to www.gomastodons.com. You can check up on your favorite teams, players, and programs anytime you like. Again, the official IPFW website, gomastodons.com, and that has been a work of a lot of effort, but a lot of pride, a lot of joy by Sports Information Director Rudy Jovich putting that together. 18-12 is our score. The overture isn't playing yet, but may be coming soon. IPFW up by six, and now it's time, Steve, to put the pedal to the metal and not let Ball State have any thoughts of getting back into this match.
And that's what Coach Walton is hoping for, is call this timeout now. Don't wait any longer. You know, he's out of his timeouts, but that's okay, because at this point, you know, you have 2-9, you lose an 18-12. You better... This is your last hope here to right the ship.
Cowan Lundin will continue to serve for IPFW. Chamberlain digs it out. He gets the return feed, and Pliska comes through with a dig. Ulrich on the run, hits the net, however, and bounces backward. Ball State will come away with the point.
That's a nice break. Nice break for Ball State after Pliska made a great dig. And maybe Ball State wants to just try and get, you know, 2 points for every one now. They don't necessarily have to put a big run together.
Nick Meyer with a good serve. Yost from the left side, and Ball State's gonna be called for a double hit, I believe.
No, what they're being called for is a net violation.
Okay.
And a lot of times what you wanna do, as soon as you see that, you wanna sort of look at the players. And you see there, McCarthy didn't react at all, which shows that he was in the net, and he got caught, you know. He didn't argue or question it.
Josh Cowan, 6'4 senior from Bancroft, Ontario, replacing C.J. Macias, and the senior will throw up a jump serve. McCarthy wide on the swing, on the kill attempt, and it's 20-13. Mighty Moe wearing blue and white at the moment, favoring IPFW.
And Coach Ball maybe trying to get his seniors in the match tonight, since it is senior night.
Collins, a little strong on the serve. Service error. Ball State They're still alive in this match. They trail 20-14, but in rally point scoring, anything can happen. Todd Chamberlain, 6'2 sophomore from Louisville, will serve. Just long.
And again, Ball State just really, I mean, no error is timely. But for that is very untimely.
Jared Quillen's going to come in for Oliveira, senior for senior. Again, five seniors honored prior to the start of the match tonight for IPFW. Josh Collins, Jason Hempfield, who I expect we may see shortly. Cowan Lundin, Vitor Oliveira, and Jared Quillen.
Ball State just hasn't done a good job of taking advantage of IPFW's mistakes.
Schmitz for Meyer. Lundin with a dig, high in the air. And Yost double hits it. Well, Jason Yost isn't a sitter by trade. 21-15 our score. IPFW still comfortably in front. And now we'll see Matt McCarthy serve for Ball State.
Good pass.
Lundin for Stewart, and that time the timing was better between the setter, Cowan Lundin, and the swinger, Josh Stewart.
And, you know, that's again what Yost and Ulrich have done, is that they've bided time for Stewart and Macias to sort of get back in their rhythm. And now they're seeing both be back in their rhythm, and that should pretty much close it out.
And then you got Yost with that. I think it was Jason Yost, that left-handed serve that just handcuffed Ball State.
And Ball State just has not handled his serve well all night. So when he gets it in, trouble for the Cardinals.
Get a good look at the down official there, Tom Joseph. Rumchick is dug out by Ulrich.
IPFW is going to have to D it up.
Rumchick, did it touch Stewart?
No, it's a net violation on IPFW.
Okay, the point still goes over to Ball State. It's now 23-16.
You know, at this point, it's 23-16, down by seven. Still time for Ball State. But here, they just want to let it all hang out. They just want to go for it now.
Block is wide by Meyer. Ulrich will get credit for the kill. And now it's 24-16. And Ball State may be saying the end is in sight. Let's get on the bus and head back to Muncie.
You could see that at 15-12, you could see that look on their face.
But the Dons still have to close it out. Schmitz, right side for Rumchick, and he mishits it.
Just very error-prone tonight, the Ball State Cardinals are. Untimely errors. And IPFW's been just solid in many, many different areas of the game. Ball control, blocking, getting good production out of just about everyone.
Off the touch, I think. Is that a service ace for
Ulrich?
Service
ace. And serving has been one of the very, very bright spots for IPFW tonight.
Well, that and that magical word we haven't mentioned yet, five-letter word called focus.
Well, yeah.
The Dons have been very focused tonight. They're now 4 points away from closing this match out. And Ulrich wants to delay the proceedings by serving it into the net. 26-17 our score. Cardinals trail by nine, and they have a road to hoe. And Mark Rumchick, the 6'4 senior from Orchard Park, New York, will try to get things started. A little float serve over the net.
Good pass.
Right side for Yost. Oh, nice block. Looked like Chamberlain and Clark were both there. 2 points in a row for the Cardinals. Yep. It's now 26-18.
They just got to look. They can't look at the lead right now. They just got to look 1 point at a time. Take it as it comes.
Twice they've served it at Stewart in the front of the net, and Ulrich just said, nuts to this. And now we're going to see substitutions. Oliveira, the senior, and we mentioned earlier Jason Hemphill, a senior, 6'4 out of North Pole, Alaska. Love that name. Both on the floor for Arnie Ball's Volley Dons. And Hemphill will serve. Festive IPFW crowd. Hits the top of the net. When it's going your way, it's going your way.
Couldn't have said it any better.
And somewhere in the background, I'm hearing Don Meredith warming up. Turn out the lights, and I'm not going to sing it.
Please do.
We get thrown off the air. Schmitz to Meyer. Nice dig by Ulrich. Lundin left side for Collins. Match point. Turn out the lights. The party's over. Never mind.
Never mind.
29-18.
Let me turn down my headset here, Mike.
And TV sets are getting clicked off all over the all over Allen County. Jason Hemphill serving for the match. Dines up 29-18 in game three. And it's long.
Well, they got a lot of room now to work. They've got 10 chances here to get a match point. Crowd stays on their feet. And by the way, if you didn't come down tonight, thanks for watching. But boy, what a good crowd we had tonight.
You should get the number in the post-match report. Jason Hempel hits it into the net. It is in a Ball State point, I think. IPFW thought the block was wide.
I think what they're saying is it hit Jason on the way out.
29-20. And there it is.
Footfault.
Footfault, and what a way to have this match end.
Well, that sort of sums it up for the way Ball State played tonight.
Game,
a little error prone. And
game three goes to the IPFW Valley Dimes 30-20. They win the match 3-0, 30-24, 30-25, 30-20. Dons improved to 17-7 overall, 8-3 in MIVA play. Cardinals dropped to 14-11 overall and 6-4 in the conference. Players and coaches congratulating each other at center court. We'll take a break and come back and talk about this match. Again, IPFW prevails and avenges an earlier defeat in Muncie. You're watching IPFW Volleyball on College 5 Sports.
I've gone away to a college where the class size is small.
I've gone away to a college with a beautiful campus.
I've gone away to a college that cares about diversity.
I've gone away to a college where I get to live in my own apartment instead of living in a dorm room.
I've gone away to a college that really isn't that far away at all.
I go to IPFW.
IPFW.
I go to IPFW.
To find out more about college life at IPFW, go to our website. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
What's it like when you hear your calling? Will you remember where you were? Will you ignore it? Or will you listen? What if it calls you to go halfway around the world? To share your skills? To serve people you've never met. To do things you never thought you could. What will you do when you hear your calling? Peace Corps, life is calling. How far will you go?
Pizza!
Pizza!
Must eat. Wait, what is this? Capsicum annum? Agaricus bisporus? Allium sepa?
Can we eat this?
Peppers, mushrooms, and onions? Eat your pizza, man.
Funny.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back, everybody. Hilliard Gates Sports Center. IPFW victorious tonight over arch rival Ball State, winning in straight sets, 30-24, 30-25, 30-20. And we're going to be joined now by one of the guys who helped make this win possible, Jason Yost, the junior out of San Diego, California, is sitting between Steve Florio and myself. And Jason, first and foremost, congratulations on the win. Talk about this match against Ball State.
Well, it was important for second place in the conference. Obviously, huge rivalry, most fans I've ever played in front of, and we just wanted to get a win for our seniors also.
Briefly, tell our viewers a little bit about yourself, because you come from the left coast.
I haven't been playing volleyball very long. I started in high school. I sent a tape to Coach Ball, and he let me come out here, and I think it's just because I'm left-handed. I enjoy the beach, and I'm glad to be here in Fort Wayne.
Well, that doesn't work then. Enjoy the beach. Glad to be here in Fort Wayne.
What led you to come here? Was it Coach Ball's magical words of wisdom that led you to come from the West Coast to the cold Midwest?
I wasn't talking to any schools on the West Coast, and a coach from another college approached me and asked me where I was going and mentioned this place, and so I sent an email, and they responded right away, and it just went from there.
Last weekend against Mercyhurst and Quincy, we had Coach Ball on the internet, and he told us that you came into your own when the team went back to California for a couple of matches. You got to play in front of family and friends, and that seemed to break the ice, so to speak, and you've been playing well ever since.
Well, it was definitely a motivation. My dad finally got to see me play at this level, and he wasn't able to come out to Fort Wayne, obviously. And I know, Coach gave me a chance, and I stepped it up big, and I've been playing steady ever since and just want to help this team win.
What you may not know is you led IPFW in kills tonight with 15, one shy of your season high that you've had twice, with 16 kills. But IPFW got off with a great start, 8-0. And I think they were ranked as high as fifth in the country. And then you stumbled a little bit. You ran into tough sledding with Ohio State twice and Ball State, and went out to California and lost a couple of times. But you've righted the ship, and you've won your last four matches in a row right at the right time, right near the end of the regular season before postseason play.
Yeah, practice has been getting really intense. We've got focused on winning the MEVA tournament and just keeping our steady play, and we're starting to peak at the right time, so I hope that we can continue this into the tournament.
Steve, any questions for Jason?
Well, I mean, you said you've never played in front of a crowd like this. What does a win like this feel? What do you feel like a win like this does for you, for IPFW heading into the postseason?
Well, obviously, most people probably know what they did to us last time we played. When we played at Ball State, it was kind of embarrassing. We played pretty bad, and it was good to have an electric crowd here and just, you know, really play well and get excited and just run them over.
So that's been on your guys' minds since the loss, huh?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Well, Jason, we appreciate you taking a few moments of time. Again, belatedly welcome to IPFW. Congratulations on leading the team in kills tonight, and we wish you nothing but the best of luck the rest of the way. There's still a couple of matches next week, and then the real fun starts, because
that's
I know that you and your teammates would love to make probably two more trips down to Columbus.
That's right. And then, so I think we need, seven more wins in a row now? I think that's the goal.
Something like that. But again, congratulations and good luck.
Thank you very much.
We've been chatting with Jason Yost, the junior transfer out of San Diego, California. Again, IPFW victorious tonight, defeating Ball State, 3-0. We'll take a break, and Steve Florio and I will come back and look at the numbers. Again, you're watching IPFW Volleyball on College 5 Sports.
Are you in there? What's up? The show's a 7. Whoa.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Living with diabetes is the pets.
When I wake up, the first thing I have to do is check my blood sugar.
I just want to feel like all the other kids without pricking my fingers or injecting myself with insulin.
Diabetes is rough on my whole family.
When I was diagnosed, my mom couldn't stop crying. But imagine a cure.
Right now, as many as 3 million children and adults are living with type 1 diabetes. They will never outgrow it. Some will face complications like kidney failure, blindness, and heart disease. That's why the science the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation is supporting is so critical. Imagine a cure.
I've gone away to a college where the class size is small.
I've gone away to a college with a beautiful campus.
I've gone away to a college that cares about diversity.
I've gone away to a college where I get to live in my own apartment instead of living in a dorm room.
I've gone away to a college that really isn't that far away at all.
I go to IPFW.
IPFW.
I go to IPFW.
To find out more about college life at IPFW, go to our website. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back again, everybody. The post-match report, so to speak. Mike Moss and Steve Floyer here at the Hurley Gate Sports Center, where many of the 2,163 fans are still here. The 10th-ranked IPFW Vowie Dons knock off the 15th-ranked Ball State Cardinals tonight, 30-24, 30-25, 30-20. As you see, the tradition continues with IPFW volleyball, be it men or women. The players will sign autographs following the completion of a match, whether they win or whether they lose. And Steve, we're going to see some highlights here. And boy, Mighty Moe decided to wear blue and white tonight.
Yeah, well, IPFW had a lot to do with that. They served real tough. They passed and played great defense. And they got great results out of two players that aren't necessarily leaned upon for offense. And here you see Jason Yost, who just tore it up tonight on his serve and also offensively.
We'll go through the numbers momentarily, but on Jason's numbers, but just individually, a team-high 15 kills, two service aces, and seven digs.
There you saw something that worked really well for the Dons tonight, kills off of the block, especially the triple block. Even though there was a triple up, they were still able to bang it off the hands and get some kills. And then you see IPFW did a nice job tonight of making sure their block turned in, and they did not get used very much. They did not get hit off of very much. Again, there's really a textbook example of turning your block in.
Macias and Oliveira on that occasion. Chamberlain with a jump serve for Ball State. IPFW able to return it.
Yost with a good swing, but nice coverage by IPFW there on the block. And then Ulrich punching one through. It's a long rally here. And this is something that the Dons did really well, is they stayed in long rallies. And they ultimately won a bunch of them, but even if they didn't win them, it just made a statement, you're just not going to get many free points.
And then the Ball State swing, and it's wide. Dan McNerney.
Quirky jump float that can cause some trouble. Another scrappy rally. It's just showing that IPFW is not going to go out without a fight, and that sends a message to a team mentally that they're going to have to work real hard.
Again, Jason Yost with that left-hand swing. You said it earlier, Steve.
A benefit of the overpass because of the tough serve.
Not that many southpaws in men's volleyball, and IPFW fortunate to have Jason Yost.
You know, and Yost jokingly said in our interview that Coach Ball probably wanted him just because he was a lefty. And it's probably not just because he was a lefty, but
it doesn't
probably
hurt.
Helped his cause. Yeah, because, again, they're rare, but they're really valuable, lefties.
Again, IPFW playing hard. Good swing there by Yost. And Ball State just didn't have the answers tonight.
No, their ball control struggled. IPFW poured on a tough serve and, you know, took advantage of the tough passing, and IPFW passed well in their own right. It's just everything went right. Everything that you want to get out of a volleyball match, IPFW got out of it. Again, right. They got ball control. They served tough, forcing Ball State to pass poorly and just be in trouble all night, and never let them get comfortable or in a groove. And then again, Yost and Ulrich just were just almost unstoppable tonight.
Yeah, you see first a corkscrew serving of Brock Ulrich, then the jump float serving of Josh Stewart.
You know, and CJ Macias actually quietly ended up with 10 kills tonight. And again, that's because the great offense of Yost and Ulrich just enabled them to enabled Macias to sort of get his rhythm back. He had an off night, and it just took the pressure off him, because a lot of times when he's having an off night, the pressure's still on him.
And then the last highlight you saw was the service ace by Cowan Lundin. A quick look at the final numbers, and I think they'll come up on the screen momentarily. IPFW, 45-33 edge in kills. They hit 320 for the match to 126 for Ball State. IPFW had 40 assists to 31 for the Cardinals. Ball State outblocked them 5-4, but Diggs, critically important, when you have two defensive teams matching up, 33-27 advantage for IPFW. We said earlier, individually, Jason Yost, 15 kills, Brock Ulrich with 14, and C.J. Macias, 10 to lead IPFW. Nick Meyer with 10 leading the way for the Ball State Cardinals. 39 assists for Cowan Lundin and 27 for the freshman Jeff Schmitz. But now you're looking at a situation where IPFW has won four matches in a row. They have two matches left, a non-conference match next Friday night here at the Gate Center against Rutgers Newark. And then that long bus ride to Quincy, Illinois, where they'll round out MIVA play next Saturday night against the Quincy Hawks.
Right.
And then depending upon how the other conference matches shake out, I think it's a pretty safe assumption that IPFW will be hosting a quarterfinal match in the MIVA postseason tournament, but against whom remains to be seen.
Right, right.
And then they're going to have to take that trip should they win that first game in the postseason down to Columbus, because Ohio State is going to lock up home court advantage. And
yep.
And they might as well send a message to the Buckeyes that we mean business and we're going to play on your floor in the Final Four.
Well, you know, they have a lineup that the Buckeyes haven't seen yet. Both losses to the Buckeyes came with a different lineup, CJ on the right side. I got to say, this looks like the lineup. And that's why you play a season. You try and find out what works and you play a whole season. And I believe Coach Ball has found what works.
Yeah, again, a great night here. Senior night celebrated. Five IPFW seniors played it very, very well, and they win this match, making up for that loss on February 23rd down in Muncie. Well, that's just about going to do it. We want to thank the College 5 production crew, the IPFW athletic staff, the city of Fort Wayne, Comcast Cablevision, and especially the IPFW Office of University Relations and Communications for their contributions to this College 5 sports telecast. This telecast of IPFW Sports is copyrighted and it's the sole property of the College Cable Access Center and IPFW. Unauthorized duplication, exhibition, rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of this event without expressed written consent is strictly prohibited. We hope you've enjoyed this telecast of IPFW Sports, and we thank you again for joining us tonight. For Steve Florio, this is Mike Maas saying so long for now. Once again, the 10th-ranked IPFW Valley Dons knock off the 15th-ranked Ball State Cardinals by scores of 30-24, 30-25, and 30-20, improving to 17-7 overall and 8-3 in MIVA play. We will see you down the road, but now it's time for us to bid you adieu as we finally say goodnight from the Hilliard Gates Sports Center here on the campus of IPFW.